Dawn Porter first made herself known to us as a writer and journalist before presenting television programmes on Channel 4, including a drastic diet show in which she slimmed to the dimensions of a whippet. Fortified with chips, she then went on to make a series of programmes about people whose love lives were a little out of the mainstream, in a hippie commune, a geisha bar, and in the sort of wife markets of the Ukraine. Her own love life went spectacularly mainstream when she married last year the brilliant actor and comedian Chris O'Dowd, now one of Hollywood's hottest stars. To mark their union, they wore matching onesies, and she adopted the O from his name, and so we present to you now, mesdames, messieurs, burnished with the lustre of the woman's hour power list, Dawn O. Porter, with her inheritance tracks.
The track that I've inherited is The Speed of the Sound of Loneliness by Nancy Griffith. It reminds me of my dad. He's always strummed it on the guitar, and when Chris and I got married last year, we wanted our dad to sing a song while we signed a register, and we both said, without realising, that the song that reminded us of our dads was The Speed of the Sound of Loneliness. Two dads on guitar while we signed the register, and they sang it beautifully.
You come home late and you come home early. You come home big when you're feeling small.
I love the lyric. You come home late and you come home curly. Sometimes you never come home at all. It was a big choice to have that playing when we signed the register. It's not a song about a great relationship, but relationships are tough, and I just think it's one of the most beautiful, tragic, awkward songs, and I just love it.
You've broken the speed of the sound of loneliness. You're out there running just to be on the run.
I didn't actually live with my dad growing up. I was brought up by my aunt and uncle in Guernsey, and my dad was up in Scotland. And we'd go up there for Easter holidays and summer holidays, and the guitar was definitely central to seeing my dad. He lives in a caravan on the edge of Loch Lomond, and there's just the sound of the guitar coming out of it all the time. I actually bought him a new guitar for Christmas this year, and it was an amazing thing. I've just never seen anybody so happy with a present, and he loves it so much that he's actually hurt his fingers from playing too much.
So what in the world's come over you? What in heaven's name have you done? You've broken the speed of the sound of loneliness. You're out there running just to be on a run.
My mum and dad actually got divorced when I was one, and so my mum moved with my sister and I down to Guernsey, and we lived with my grandparents, and then my mum died when I was seven, and 3 years later my aunt and uncle took my sister and I off my grandparents' hands, and so my aunt and uncle became my parents, and then there's my dad. So I have three parents, really, and always have. I've always referred to them as my parents because I think whoever brings you up in your teenage years, you see that way.
It's a mighty mean and a dreadful sorrow. It's crossed the evil land today.
Red fingernails. When I see people with red fingernails, I instantly think of my mum. And also, if I get a waft of Chanel No. 5, I get this kind of full body feeling. But I don't really remember her. It's an odd thing. It's all a bit like a dream. It was 3 days before my seventh birthday that she died. So it's very strange because you look at pictures and you know this is the most important person in your world up until the age of seven, and you can't really remember what they sound like and, you know, who they were. So I love my family telling me stories about her.
You're out there running just to be on the run.
Last time I was in Guernsey, I was buying some crisps in a little shop by the beach, and this man was staring at me, and I just did that stop staring at me type reaction, and he just came over to me and he said, "Who is your mother?" And I just knew that he recognised me because I'm so much like her, because people tell me that all the time. Then I remembered him, and he was one of her boyfriends. That makes her sound good. But she did. She had a few boyfriends. And I looked at his face and I got this overwhelming feeling of, you know me and you loved her. And we had this really magical moment whilst buying crisps.
The
The track that I will pass on is Bruce Springsteen, Born to Run. It just does something to me, this piece of music. It makes me really excited and makes me kind of want to punch the air. It's also the song that Chris and I kind of fell in love to. One of our first major outings as a couple was to Glastonbury, and Bruce Springsteen was headlining. His aura on stage is just something else, and we were so taken by this. And while Born to Run came on, Chris and I had a loving embrace and a bit of a snog and told each other we loved each other, and it was really lovely. So at our wedding, our first dance was Born to Run. Baby, We Were Born to Run. I think as a couple, especially Chris and I, feel like we're on a real journey together. We have an extraordinary life. And the idea that, you know, Bruce gets Wendy on the back of the bike and they just drive off and they have, they're just in it together. And Chris and I really, really relate to that. Just wrap your legs around these velvet rims and strap your hands across my engines. For someone who never cared about getting married, I find being married just the best thing I've ever done. I didn't realise how many insecurities I had in the relationship. And before you get married, there's always an out. And the thing that I felt as soon as we'd got married is that there was no out. This is it. I love being married. I'd highly recommend it. I feel so much more comfortable with the idea of thinking that we'll have children since we got married. And I think a lot of my issues with not wanting to have children before were the fear of doing it on my own. And now that Chris and I are just so together in such a team, I'm finding myself getting broody for the first time, which I'm still getting used to, but it's a nice feeling. My dad is the kind of guy who would know all about Bruce Springsteen. My aunt and uncle, not so much. They're very much Radio 4 listeners. And to play them a song like Born to Run and see their reaction is always quite fun. But I think if the day comes where I have children, it's a timeless song. And it's a song where, you know, say this is what Mummy and Daddy danced to on their wedding day, and they'll love it as much as we do now.